Welcome to the subcommittee of the Health and Human Services Committee. We have one bill on our agenda today, House Bill 520. It's for a hearing only. We're not voting on this bill today. Let me just remind you, we're going to limit individuals to 2 minutes just because we've got a long list of people signed up and we may not get to everybody today. And we'll get started.
Thank you, Senators, for ridding Georgia of TikTok and Chinese tracking. Yes. Mental Health Equity 1.0 HB 1013 was gutted by senators a year ago. Senators prudently removed numerous references to the World Health Organization's definition for mental health and stopped the possibility of TikTok-like Chinese biometric wristbands and components from being used in Georgia mental health care. Now Mental Health Equity 2.0 HB 520 unexplainably allows for TikTok-like tracking, but 10 times worse. Mental Health Parity 2.0 fails to provide any meaningful definitions, as you've heard here. What is mental health? What is mental illness? What is serious mental illness? What is monitoring? HB 520 cites these things numerous times. Who monitors? How do you monitor? Are these going to use Chinese components, pieces, and parts for monitoring? Who maintains the data? What if the company that's there sells their company? Then what happens to the data? Presumably, these questions will be left up to a few elite mental health czars. And if I'm wrong, then what would be the harm in banning any and all aspects related to China as it results to any and all monitoring of any kind relative to Mental Health Equity 2.0? There would be no harm, so why not do that? But the most important information is during last year's Senate hearings for HB 1013 was that Mental Health Equity was overturned on March 22, 2022 by the Federal Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals, Witt versus United Behavioral Health. Had that been known by this body a year ago, Georgia Mental Health Equity would not have just been gutted, but it would have been halted. The very name of last year's bill, HB 1013, Mental Health Equity, was based on the notion that a federal mandate existed for mental health equity. There are ample arguments during last year's hearing based on a federal mandate which no longer exists. That was deliberately withheld from this body. I have supplied, and I believe somebody's going to pass out the open records that I obtained, to where the proponents and one of the bill sponsors deliberately withheld that information during the Senate hearings last year. That is wrong. That should not have stopped. That should have stopped. Please oppose HB 10, HB 520. Table it. Don't let this legislation go any further. Thank you.
Next, Roland Boone.
Thank you.